Now that we know what radical notation is, I've got a couple practice problems to make sure we have it down. We're going to start here with the fourth root of 625. Now that means we're looking for the non-negative number whose fourth power is 625. Now maybe you know that right off the top of your head, but if you don't, well, we can start by factoring 625. You might recognize that as 25 squared, but if you don't, you can still pull out a factor of 5. We can look at this as the fourth root of 5 times, divide 5 into 625, you'll get 125. And you can pull out another factor of 5. Maybe this is 5 times 5. Pull out a factor of 5 from 125, you'll have 25. And of course, that's 5 squared. So this is the fourth power of 5 times 5 times 5 squared. That gives us a total of 4 fives. So this is the fourth root of 5 to the fourth. So 5 is the number that you raise to the fourth power to get 625. And our answer is 5. Let's try another one. Now, here we have a cube root. So we're looking for the number that we cube to get negative 0.216. You might be able to just guess the answer again here, but if you can't, then what are you going to do? Well, the first step is to deal with the negative. The only way to get a negative number when you cube something is if you start off with a negative number. So we know that we're going to be cubing a negative number here. So we can just pull out that negative. So now we're looking for the negative of the cube root of 0.216. I'm not so sure how to deal with that, but I do know how to deal with fractions. So I'm going to write that decimal as a fraction. And now I'm looking at the cube root of a quotient. Well, we can just use one of our exponent rules there. We can also look at this as a quotient of cube roots. Just take the cube root of 216 over the cube root of 1,000. Cube root of 1,000, that's easy. 1,000 is 10 cubed, so the cube root of 10 cubed, that's just 10. But what about 216? Well, factor 216. Take out a factor of 2. Take out another factor of 2, take out another factor of 2, and now we see that 216 is 2 times 2 times 2, that's 2 cubed, and 27 is 3 cubed. 2 cubed times 3 cubed, that's 6 cubed. 216 is 6 cubed. So this is the negative of the cube root of 6 cubed divided by the cube root of 10 cubed. Of course, cube root of 6 cubed, you cube 6 to get 6 cubed. Cube root of 10 cubed is 10. We have negative 6 over 10. Question's written as a decimal. We write our final answer as a decimal as well. And we're done.